Dear students, today we are going to discuss about the application electronic mail or email. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the different protocols that can be used for creating the email, sending the email and accessing the email through internet. So the main protocols which can be involved in email procedure is SMTP, that is Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. POP, that is Postoffice Protocol. Then INAP, Internet Mail Access Protocol. Then MIME, Multipurpose Internet Mail Extension Protocol. So these are the four main protocols which are associated with electronic mail. And let us discuss all these protocols in this session. Electronic mail is seen as the most widely used and popular applications of internet. So in nowadays, each and everything is contacted or it will be informed to various persons through this electronic mail. Mail delivery differs fundamentally from other uses of networks. So this mail delivery process is a very complex process or a very difficult process compared to other applications that are available in the internet. And in order to handle the delayed delivery mail system, the internet uses a technique called spoofing technique. So electronic mail or email is one of the most popular application that is available on the internet. And this mail delivery mechanism is something which is different from all other applications on the internet. And in order to handle the delayed mail systems, the internet is using a technology called spoofing. Now let us see what are the major components that are involved in electronic mail. Mainly there are three components which is associated with email sending. The first component is user agent, second is mail server, and third is Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, that is SMTP. Let us discuss all these three components in detail. The first component is user agent, and user agent is also known as mail reader. So this user agent is responsible for composing, editing, reading, saving, forwarding mail messages. Example, Eudora, Outlook, ELM, Mozilla Thunderbird. These are some examples for user agents. Then outgoing, incoming messages are stored on the web server. So if you are looking at this particular diagram, we can see that there are several mail servers, and these mail servers are communicated through a protocol called SMTP. And for each mail server, there are some user agents associated with each and every mail server. For this particular mail server, there is a single user agent. If you are looking at this mail server, we can see that three user agents are associated with this particular mail server. And the third one, two user agents are associated. So user agent means these are mail readers. And this user agent is responsible for composing, editing, reading, saving, forwarding mail messages. At the same time, it is responsible for outgoing messages, incoming messages which are stored on the server. The second important component in the email architecture is the mail server. So, mail server is actually a mailbox containing incoming messages for user. So message queue is there, it is of outgoing mail messages, and SMTP protocol means it is between the mail servers to send email messages. So in this particular email architecture, some of the mail servers will act as client and some of the servers or the corresponding machines will act as the server. So sending mail is termed as the client server, and receiving mail should be the server in this particular context. So mail server means mail servers containing mail boxes which contains incoming messages for the user. Then message queue means a message queue of outgoing mail messages are there. Then SMTP protocol is used to communicate between this mail servers to send mail messages. And another point is that the server, mail server, which is responsible for sending mail is termed as the client. And the mail server, which is responsible for receiving the mail, is termed as the server. Now let us discuss the third important component which is associated with email, that is SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. We know that email is one of the most widely used internet application, and email is an asynchronous communication medium. So the main protocols associated with email are SMTP and POP3. So for sending the emails, SMTP along with MIME protocol is used, and for receiving the emails, POP3 or IMAP protocol is used. So SMTP is the basic protocol which is used to send email from one machine to another. SMTP has capacity to transmit simple text messages only. It uses information written on envelope of email like message header, contains the recipient address and other information. It does not look at the contents or message body. So there are several protocols which are associated with email. The main protocols which is associated with sending emails is SMTP and MIME. SMTP is Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, and MIME is Multi-Purpose Internet Mail Extension. And for receiving the emails, two important protocols used are POP3 or IMAP. POP3 is Postfix Protocol, and IMAP is Internet Mail Access Protocol. Now we see what is this SMTP is for. SMTP is a basic protocol which is used to send email from one person or one machine to another. So this is a basic email sending protocol, and SMTP is having some limitation. It has only the capacity to transmit simple text messages. So we cannot include any multimedia files in the case of SMTP protocol. This SMTP can handle only simple text messages, and it uses information written on envelope of email like message header, contains the recipient address and other information. So for transferring the corresponding email, this SMTP protocol uses the contents on the envelope of that particular email, like the message header, what should be the purpose or subject line, what should be the recipient address. All these things are used by the SMTP, and it does not look at contents of message body. SMTP is not bothered about what should be the message inside that particular email. It does not look the content of that particular email. Mail is created by the user agent program. So normally the emails are generated by the user agent programs like Outlook or Thunderbird, like that. The email messages are queued and sent input to SMTP sender program. SMTP sender program is responsible for sending the mail. They are working as a server program and is a daemon process in Unix. When the user agent composed an email and send button is pressed, it will open a connection to the nearest SMTP server with port number 25. Then SMTP server will act as SMTP server as well as SMTP client. SMTP server will get a queue of mails. Each of it will have a mail header as well as mail body. SMTP server will forward the received mails to another SMTP server. The mail will be forwarded to intermediate SMTP server. The SMTP server will finally deposit the mail to the final mailbox. So here the emails are normally created by a user agent program like Outlook or Outlook Express, something like that. The email messages are queued and sent input to the SMTP sender program. So the SMTP is having a program called sender program, and in this sender program is responsible for sending the emails, and they are working as a server program. And actually this sending process is a process in Unix OS. So when the user agent composed an email and send button is pressed, so whenever we are composing an email and the send button is pressed, it will open a connection to the nearest SMTP server with port number 25. So what happens is whenever we are clicking the send button, it will establish a connection with nearest mail server on port number 25. SMTP server will act as SMTP server as well as SMTP client. An SMTP server is responsible for acting as a sender as well as a receiver. That is why SMTP server will act as SMTP server and SMTP client. SMTP servers are termed as senders and SMTP clients are termed as receivers. SMTP server will get a queue of mails, each of it will have a mail header as well as a mail body. So this server or sender will have a queue of emails where all these emails are having a header as well as a mail body. The SMTP server will forward the received mails to another SMTP server. The mail will be forwarded to intermediate SMTP server. The SMTP server will finally deposit the mail to the final mailbox. So what happens here, it is this SMTP server is having a queue of mails with mail header as well as mail body, and this server will forward the received mails to another SMTP server. The mail will be forwarded to intermediate SMTP server, and the SMTP server will finally deposit the mail to final mailbox, the server which is responsible for holding the recipient. Finally, the mail should be delivered to the client server or client SMTP server. See, the in email system, SMTP is a protocol which is used for transferring messages from one machine to another, and this SMTP, simple mail transfer protocol, uses the or it seeks the help of transmission control protocol to transfer the email messages from client to server. So in order to establish the connection over a particular machine, it uses the port number 25. Then in case of this SMTP, direct transfer of messages should be happened from sending server to the receiving server. And in case of this message transfer, there are three phases. First phase is handshaking, second is transfer of messages, and third thing is closure of connection. So in the first phase means handshaking. Handshaking means a new connection is established, and both the sending server as well as receiving server makes a greeting upon each other. Then after setting or after doing the shaking or handshaking or after doing the greeting, then it will transfer the messages. Then after transferring the messages from sending server to receiving server, both the servers should quit the corresponding connection. Then command response interaction. So these two servers are interacted through commands, and the response will be given back between these two servers. Commands are in the format of ASCII text and response is in the format of status call or phrase. So remember, this electronic mail uses simple mail transfer protocol to transfer the messages or emails from one machine to another. And in order to make the interconnectivity between these two machines, we are using the TCP protocol, or this SMTP is using the, or it seeks the help of transmission control protocol to transfer the message from client to server. And this particular protocol is establishing the connection over port number 25. Then in case of this mail transferring mechanism, a direct transfer should occur from the sending server to the receiving server. And in case of this mail transfer, there are three phases are there. First phase is the handshaking. Handshaking means greeting between or getting between the sending server and receiving server. Both the servers says a hi to make a proper connection channel. Then the second stage is transfer of messages. Then third stage is after transferring all the messages, they want to quit the corresponding server. That is the third stage, closure of connection. Then both the servers, sending server as well as receiving server, should interact with each other through commands and response. If any request is there, that will be forwarded in the format of command, and response will be given back to the server by the form of status code or phrases. And commands are established in the format of ASCII text, and response is in the format of status codes. This is an diagram showing a simple SMTP mail flow. And inside this diagram, here we are having an email client, and this is our SMTP sender. So this email client is producing a particular email by specifying the header values and message body, and they will click the corresponding send button. So what happens is this email should be forwarded to the corresponding SMTP sending server. So this SMTP sender, so TCP to port 25 on SMTP receiver. So what happens is this sender will make a connection to SMTP receiver server. So TCP from foreign SMTP sender to local port 25. So the connection is established between the sender and receiver through port number 25. And after that, the SMTP receiver puts it in the corresponding user. Receiver will put the corresponding message in the user's mailbox. So this is a normal flow of email messages through this SMTP with the help of TCP protocol. So we in the diagram, we already seen that there will be a sender server and a receiver server is there. SMTP sender, it takes messages from the queue, transmits to proper destination host via SMTP transaction over one or more TCP connections to port number 25. So SMTP sender, it takes the messages from a particular sending queue, then it will transmit to the proper destination host via SMTP transaction over one or more TCP connections to over the port number 25. And SMTP receiver is there. SMTP receiver server, it acts as the receiver of emails. Mails received by the SMTP receiver at the final destination, it will finally connect it to the user mailboxes. Same SMTP server acts as SMTP sender and SMTP receiver. They act as receiver when receiving mails. So SMTP servers can act both as sender as well as receivers. In case of if the server is acting as a sender, it takes the message from the corresponding queue and transmit it to the proper destination via SMTP transaction over one or more TCP connections to port number 25. And in case if the server is acting as a SMTP receiver, mail received by the SMTP receiver at the final destination and it will finally connect it to the user mailboxes. Same SMTP server will act as a SMTP sender and SMTP receiver, and they act as receiver when receiving the corresponding emails. Here we can see a sample SMTP interaction. Here S mentions the server and C mentions the client. Yes, 220hamburger.edu. So here the server is having the domain hamburger.edu. Then the client hellocraves.fr. He is drafting a particular message and it makes a greeting towards the corresponding server. Then a server responds it with 250 hellocraves.fr, pleased to meet you. That is a greeting. Handshaking, these three first three steps are the handshaking process. Then after that, client writes mail from alice@craves.fr, then 250. The sender is okay. Server responding back that the sender is okay. then recipient to bob@hamburger.edu. So sender says that the recipient is also okay. Server says that the recipient is also okay. Then after that, the client will give the data. Enter mail end with dot on a line by itself. Do you like ketchup? How about the pickles? All these things are the data inside the corresponding email. Then after that, it puts a full stop. Full stop gives the idea that the mail is over. So the client, after specifying the full stop by client, server gives the message that it will be accepted for delivery by specifying the status code 250. Then what the client do is, the client quit that particular connection because he don't want any other, or the client is not having any other emails to send. So it will quit, or it quits the corresponding connection. So server do, or server also trying to quit the connection. That is why the status code mentioned as 221. 221 means the it's closing the corresponding connection. So this type of interactions are happened in between the client and the SMTP server. We can set SMTP interaction by ourselves by using or specifying the command telnet server name by the port number 225. So we can see 220 is a reply from the server. Then we can enter hello, mail from receipt to data, quit commands, and above let's use an email without using any of the email clients. This command is used for making an interaction from. It is used for making a chat type interaction. So some of the main points which is related to simple mail transfer protocol is SMTP uses persistent connection. And SMTP requires message. This message is having a header part and body part, and it will be in 7-bit ASCII code. Then SMTP server uses CRLF. And CRLF is used to determine the end of the message. So it is a persistent connection. SMTP is a persistent connection. At the same time, this SMTP requires a message. A message means this message is having a header part and a body part. Header should contain all the details related to the sender as well as the receiver. And then the body part, what should be the text that should be transferred is enclosed in the body part, and it should be in a 7-bit ASCII format. And this SMTP server uses CRLF to mention the end of the corresponding message. Then we have to compare the SMTP protocol with HTTP. SMTP as well as HTTP is used to transfer files or data. HTTP between web client to web server, but in case of SMTP it is between mail server to mail server. That is the difference. In case of HTTP, hypertext transfer protocol, the connection is established from a web client to a web server. We know that web client is the browser and web server is a server machine which gives or which provides the corresponding web pages to the client. But in case of the simple mail transfer protocol, the connection should be established between two SMTP mail servers. One server will act as the sender and one server will act as the receiver. Now we can make the comparison or continue the comparison. HTTP is a pull operation and SMTP is a push operation. That is a basic difference. HTTP is something which is pulling, and SMTP is something which is pushing. Both have ASCII command response reaction interaction and status codes. Both of these protocols, HTTP and SMTP, are using ASCII command, and the response will be in the format of status codes. HTTP, each object is encapsulated in its own response message. So each and every object in the hypertext transfer protocol is encapsulated in a particular response message, and in case of SMTP, multiple objects sends in a single message. And this is a mail message format of SMTP. SMTP is a protocol which is used for exchanging email standard for text message format. There will be a header part and there will be a body part. Inside the header part, we are having data like to, from, subject, and it should be different from the SMTP commands. And in the body of the corresponding SMTP message packet, it will contains the message of the email and it contains only ASCII characters. And this SMTP protocol is used for transferring simple text messages. So the message format or packet is in the format of a header part and a body part. Header includes all the details like to address, from address, subject of the email. And in the body part, it should enclose the data of the email. This is a simple scenario which explains Alice sends message to Bob. Alice uses a particular UA to compose, user agent to compose a message, and to this particular address, bob@someschool.edu. Then Alice user agent sends message to her mail server and message is placed in the message queue. So what happens here, it is Alice is a person who is trying to send a message to this particular address, bob@someschool.edu. So this particular message will be forwarded to the Alice mail server and message is placed in the message queue of on the server side. So this is Alice. So he is trying to compose a particular mail using a user agent. And after composing the mail, he presses the send button. So what happens is this mail is forwarded to the mail server. On the mail server side, this particular message is on a queue. Then client side of SMTP opens a TCP connection with Bob's mail server. So the client side of this SMTP opens, this transfer should be happened through transmission control protocol and it should be established over port number 25. Then SMTP client sends Alice message over the TCP connection and Bob's mail server places the message in Bob's mailbox. Bob's inbox is user agent to read the message. So this mail server can be communicated to this receiving mail server through a TCP connection. And the bob@someschool.edu is on the corresponding mail server, this mail server. So this Alice mail server establishes a connection towards Bob's mail server over the TCP. Then Bob's mail server places the corresponding message in Bob's mailbox. So what this receiving mail server do is, it sends the or it places the corresponding message in the Bob's mailbox. Whenever Bob invokes his corresponding user agent, he can read that particular message. So here for composing as well as reading the message, we need a user agent. Then next thing is that we need two mail servers. One is on the sender side and one is on the receiving side. Only through this mail servers are establishing a TCP connection over port number 25, and only through that particular connection, the messages, email messages are transferred. After transferring all the messages, they will quit that particular connection. That is the connection between this sending mail server and the receiving mail server. Here we can see some of the mail access protocols. In the previous lecture, we seen the corresponding protocols which are used to send the email. SMTP is the protocol which is used for transferring, or it is used for sending the emails. SMTP, with the help of TCP protocol, it establishes a connection over the mail servers, and hence the email should be transferred from one system to the another. And in case of a mail accessing, on the corresponding receiver side, we have to use some protocols for accessing the email. And the main protocols under this category is POP3, that is Post Office Protocol 3, then IMAP4, Internet Mail Access Protocol 4, and MIME stands for Multi-Purpose Internet Mail Extension. So mail access protocols, we already seen the scenario of Ali sends a message to Bob, and here we are having a user agent on Ali's side and Bob's side, and this Ali's user agent contacts to the SMTP mail server, that is the sender. This server acts as the sender, and on the receiver side, Bob is a receiver and he can access his mail through a user agent. This user agent got the email from a receiver mail server, and this is a normal scenario of transferring an email. And SMTP is a delivery storage to receiver server. And mail access protocol involves some protocol which can be the protocols which are established on the receiver side to access the emails. So the main protocol, it is working on the receiver side for retrieving the corresponding email from the server, is POP, that is Post Office Protocol, and it is an authorization. So it performs an authorization agent to the server and download. So in this particular protocol, it checks the authorization of the corresponding email, and then only it gives a permission to download. Then IMAP, that is Internet Mail Access Protocol, and it has having more features and it is somewhat complex. It is used for the manipulation of stored messages on the server. And HTTP is another protocol which is used for opening the mail servers like Gmail accounts, Hotmail accounts, Yahoo Mail, etc. Now we will discuss these three protocols, POP3, IMAP, in detail. Then we know what is POP3, that is Post Office Protocol. The mail client establishes a connection with its nearest SMTP receiver, and the mail client have the capability for pulling your email from SMTP receiver. So our message reaches. So the email message is currently on the receiver mail server. And from that receiver mail server, we have to pull out that email to the corresponding user. So POP3 is a particular protocol. The client POP3 software is installed on the recipient machine, and server POP3 software is installed on the mail server. So all the mail servers is having a POP3 server version, and all the client software, that is our web browser, is installed with POP3 recipient machine version. The client opens a connection with the server on TCP port number 110. So this particular protocol establishes a connection with the server at port number 110, and this connection is established with the help of TCP, and this particular protocol is responsible for sending the username and password and access mail the one by one. And IMAP provides extra features to our email mechanism systems. So POP3 is a machine which is used, POP3 is a protocol which is used for checking the authorization of emails. So POP3 is responsible for sending the user ID as well as password towards the mail server through this TCP connection. And at the same time, this protocol is responsible for accessing the mails from the mail server. And this IMAP also provides some extra features towards this particular mail accessing session. So in case protocol, it is having two phases, authorization phase and transaction phase. So in the authorization phase, we know that authorization is a process which checks the validity of the user. So the client commands like user ID, that is declaring the username, then password, that things are checked using this call, then server responses. So it also maintains the server responses like okay or error. So if the user is providing correct user ID and password, the server provides an okay message. Otherwise, the server will provide an error message. If you are looking at the corresponding this communication slot, we can easily seen or we can easily understood this corresponding things. Server, top 3 server is ready. Then see, it provides, the client will give the user ID as POP. Server specifies that ID is okay. Then the client specifies the password as hungry. Then server says that, oh, user successfully logged on. This Bob is having the password hungry. So there will be no problem that corresponding user is a valid person or valid login. So it will make a connection between the client and this particular mail server. Now after this, so this is, these things are belonging to the authorization phase. After authorization, it moved to the transaction phase. Then transaction phase is initiated by the client. Then list message numbers, RETR, retrieve the message by number, then delete, quit. So see what the corresponding client does. It gives a command, list means all the emails should be listed. Then what happens here, it is server will list. So by getting this particular command, server lists all the corresponding emails to that particular user. Then RETR1, so the client is requesting to open the message, first message, RETR1 means retrieving the message 1. So the server gives the mail contents, message 1 contents. Then what the client do, client delete command, or client is pressing the delete button for message 1. So what happens is the server will delete that particular message. Then after that, another command, retrieving of 2. So message contents will be here it is message 2. Message 2 contents will be displayed by the corresponding server. Then after reading that, it will give another command, delete of 2. Then connection is quit by the client, and the server also provides an okay message by for quitting, and the POP3 server is signing off. Now we can see the IMAP4 protocol, that is Internet Message Access Protocol. Internet Message Access Protocol is an email accessing mechanism or email access protocol. So this IMAP is acting as an alternative for our previous protocol POP3, that is Post Office Protocol. User runs an IMAP4 client that contacts the server to retrieve messages. So user can, or the user machine is having this IMAP4 protocol client that contacts the server to retrieve the corresponding email messages for that particular user. And this IMAP is used for creating, the deleting and remaining email messages. So this IMAP is an alternative for POP3 protocol, and it is used for accessing emails. The user's client will access the corresponding mail server through this particular protocol to retrieve the email messages. And it is also responsible for creating, deleting and renaming mailboxes. Now we can see something more about this POP3 and IMAP. POP3, in the previous example, we already seen that it uses download and delete mode, and Bob cannot reread email if he changes the corresponding client. Download and keep copies of messages on different clients, and POP3 is a stateless echo sessions. And in case of IMAP, it keeps all messages in one place, that is the server. It allows user to organize messages in folders. Then IMAP keeps user state across sessions. That is the basic difference. POP3 is a stateless and IMAP is a state protocol. IMAP keeps user state across sessions, names of folders, and mappings between message IDs and folder names. All these things are correctly kept in IMAP. MIME is another type of protocol which stands for Multipurpose Internet Mail Extension, and it is used for transmission of non-ASCII data. Normally, in all the email access protocols like POP3 and IMAP, we are using only text messages which can be encoded in the ASCII type. But in case of using this MIME protocol, we can transmit some other type of data like audio files, video files, text, image files, like that. So it allows ordinary data to be encoded in ASCII and transmitted in standard email. Then the MIME header specifies version of MIME used, type of data being used, encoding used to convert data to ASCII. Then what are the features? Then support of character sets other than ASCII. So if you are encoding text in the email, it will be converted or it will be encoded to ASCII character. And if other than text are available in the corresponding email, it will be converted to some other character set. Then content type labeling system. Depending upon the content, a label can be specified. Support of non-text content in email messages. So in email messages, in addition to text or in addition to the text, we can fix some other data like videos, audios, other type of files can be also transmitted. Support for compound documents. So if an email is composed, we can place text. Then multimedia can be set in a particular mail. Like in a simple mail, we can include text, then audio files, video files, images, like that. Different types of files can be incorporated in a single email. So we already seen what all the main message contains: text, images, audio, video, and application specific data like spreadsheets, word processing documents, presentations, etc. And these are some of the content labeling mechanism or the file extensions that can be used with MIME protocol: .txt, .htm, .jpg, .gif, .wav, .mp3, .mpg, .zip. These are some type of files that can be transferred through this MIME protocol. And we move on to the summary of email mechanism. Email uses TCP/IP protocol to transmit the email messages from one mail server to another. For doing the email mechanism, we need SMTP protocol, POP3, and MIME. SMTP is a protocol which is used for sending the email, defines how a mail system on one machine transfers mail to server on another. Then POP3 and MIME. POP3 is a particular protocol which is used for accessing the email, specifies how user can retrieve contents of a mailbox, and MIME is a protocol which provides a mechanism that allows arbitrary data to be transmitted using SMTP. Which means that using this MIME protocol, we can transfer files like audio files, video files, JPG images, all these things. That is, multimedia can be included in emails using this MIME protocol. So SMTP is used for creating emails, POP3 is used for accessing emails, and MIME is used for including multimedia in our emails. Hope you understood the different protocols. Thank you.